And now, last week, cattle and food dealers from the northern part of Nigeria carried out the threat to suspend movement of commodities to the southern part of the country. And the resulting effect was scarcity of food items, which translated into astronomical rise in prices. Even as we brought you an update, let's see what Funke Adesoji brought in when she went to Agbadoke Odo Market, a suburb of Lagos Metropolis, for an on-the-spot assessment.
Agbadoke Odo Market, though in a suburb area of the Lagos Metropolis, is reputed to be one of the popular markets where food items and commodities from the northern part of the country usually touch down for distribution to other parts of Lagos and its environs. But since the blockade of cattle and foodstuffs from the north to the southwest, traders and buyers now tell their tales of woes.
Now it's supposed to get oil, cheaper one now, but it's rising up. Because if you go bush, if you want to go and buy, the thing that you buy 10,000 naira, if you want to go to the second day, it can say 23,000 naira.
Tomatoes, pepper, there's no more again. Yam, they have stopped the other things coming in. So people now, even there's no meat. So for now, the stockfish have increased price.
The closure of border between south and the northern part of the country, that no more vehicles are allowed to enter into this part of the country. When the commodity is scarce, the price will definitely skyrocket, because we have low supply and people have much more demand than what we are expecting to buy in the market. As at last week, we sell a bag of beans, the most expensive one was 40,000, 35,000, but now it is 48,000. See the difference in 1 week, it's more than 10,000 naira or something like that in a bag of beans. Now look at my shop now, that I used to upload like 500 bags, including my warehouse there. When you go there, if you can go there, no single beans there.
The non-availability of beef has not only impacted negatively on price, but others such as fresh fish, stockfish, and even cow hide, popularly known as pomo.
Without fish, some people can't eat. And without fish, some people can't. And everything is cost. In fact, egg is also cost. So everything is cost. Fish is cost. Everything, like seriously.
Let's say tomatoes, because I'll be chairman for tomato sites. So I'll be talking about tomato sites. Before this crisis enter, we are selling tomatoes 3,000 to 5. So when this thing started, like last week, they have started. Now they are selling tomatoes 30,000, 35,000. And onions they are selling before, let's say 12,000, 13,000. Now they are selling onions is 30,000. Pepper before they are selling is 3,000, 4,000, high. Now they are selling pepper is 15,000. So everything is high. If you go to Tataje side, they are selling before 5,000. Now it's 20, 25. So everything is double. So that's what is going on.
For many, this is not the time to flex muscle in the interest of Nigeria unity. They are thus appealing to both the government and the stakeholders to seek a common ground to resolve the crisis and calm frayed nerves. It is also the argument in some quarters that this stance will bring a no-win situation for both parties, which depends on each other for economic survival. Funke Adesoji, reporting for Silverbird News 24.